In this quick video, I'm gonna show you how to keep the layers of your application very cleanly separated and more importantly, very cleanly initializable. So the goal here is to be able to initialize each and every layer independent of the layer above it. So let's first talk about the layers of the application that we're gonna be using. We are using a pretty standard application. We have a persistence layer here, we have a service layer, and we have a web layer, and of course we have some other artifacts as well. And we have a very similar structure here in the test source folder. So let's start by implementing a very first test, right? We're gonna do an integration test. We're going to start with a very simple test here. We're gonna call it persistence Spring integration test, and we are simply going to initialize the Spring context. So all we care about here is that the Spring context is initializable. So we can bootstrap just the persistence configuration without any sort of other necessary dependencies. So basically what we want to make sure is that this is completely independent and can be initialized on its own. So let's do a simple test here. Okay, so that's an empty test which simply bootstraps the Spring context. So let's run this. And here we are. Okay, we have a green passing test. So that means this, at least the persistence layer, is of course fully separate and can be initialized separately. So let's now do the same thing for the service layer. We are going to create another test here. We are going to call it service. And now, of course, we need to initialize the persistence layer, and we need to initialize the service layer. Okay, so now both of these layers are initialized. However, that's it. There should be no other dependency necessary to bootstrap those two layers. We shouldn't have any dependency to anything else outside of the persistence and service layer. So let's see if that works. And we have a green light. Okay, so now we're gonna do the exact same test, but this time in the web layer, basically pulling in the persistence, the service, and the web layers, and of course some of the other layers as well, basically making sure that the application is able to start up correctly and all of these layers actually do initialize properly. So if there's any exception in any of the layers, this is the overall comprehensive test that's gonna catch that exception before you even start up the web app. Okay, so let's now start from this test. We're gonna call this web Spring integration test, and let's actually pull in the web config, and we're gonna also pull in Reddit config. And this is just because the web layer actually does use some beans out of this Reddit package. So let's now run the test and make sure it works. And it will not work the first time. Here we go. So we're getting this servlet context is required, which is basically telling us that we need a web context here. We're not instantiating a web context because we are not explicitly asking for one, but we do need one just because we have pulled in this web configuration. So in order to solve this problem, first of all, we need to get rid of the loader. We don't need that information anymore. And we are gonna use a very cool annotation that basically instructs Spring test, instructs the framework to construct a web context. Instead of the standard context, this annotation will instruct it to create a web context. So now we should be good. Let's make sure that works. Okay, so we have a green light. And there you go. This is how we can keep the layers of the application very clean, very separate from each other and make sure that there are no interdependencies between layers that should really not communicate with each other. All right, cheers everybody, see you next time.